exactly. We would like to hear some of your thoughts, sir. Bacteria. You already said a lot of your ideas on bacteria. We perceive you value bacteria a lot on our tanks. And we have been managing that with some products that we would like to have some of your idea when and what purpose to is better to use them. So we've been keeping bacteroballs in our systems.
Yeah.
About bacteroballs, some people have even questioned, can we just add more? Do we need to remove the previous balls? And do they have just bacteria or do they have a small amount of carbon source?
Okay. Then we have four different types of bacteria. We can start with the bacteroballs. The bacteroballs is made for the lazy people. These are the same bacteria which we have in Bactoplan. It's a little bit a lower amount as exactly, but there's a completely different. I know that many people claiming that the bactopods are the same like the pond for koi. So you can try that out. If you put a ball, which is for koi, it shrinks together in a reef tank within of a few 1-2 days. And the bactoplans don't do it. So there you can also have a proof that it's not the same. The problem what we have is that we have seawater. So we have to fill the balls also with seawater and not with fresh water. That's one of the points. And the normal balls you can only fill with fresh water because the salt is destroying the material. So we use a completely different material as the typical koi ponds. It is possible that the balls will not dilute completely. This is depending on the organic amount which is in the water. If there's not a lot organic there, then they keep stable or if not enough flow. But the bacteria is going step by step out. That's why I need a little bit less bacteria because they need time and the bacteria has time to come okay with the salinity in the reef tank. Because if you check bacteria solutions, you will find out none of them has 35 salinity, they're much lower. We reproduce it with 1%. This is the highest what we can do. The reason for that is very simple. The companies who are producing the bacteria, which are really professional, they have really high, really big and very expensive reactors for breeding this type of bacteria. And the metal of these reactors cannot put more than 1%. And we are not as that big market that they accept that we kill them the reactors for a few hundred thousands. So this is the most what we can do. But we adding the salt then later and we're getting to 1%. So we have a little bit the right type of bacteria for the reef tank. So that's one of the difference. And we have a very high amount of bacteria inside. So we have mostly over 1 billion bacteria by milliliter. If you look for some American products, you can find out that they need 30 milliliters for dosing. We need only 3 to 4 and have the same amount of, and have even more bacteria more than 100 times in. But I have a question for you now. Have you an idea why we have to redose the bacteria? Because all bacteria what you buy here, they are living bacteria. So, but all, like we do also, we ride those all 14 days. So why you think this? You have an idea?
Maybe I don't think if we if I would be right on that, but we are very, very interested in reading in groups and all that. When we have seen that over time, there is somehow a tendency of the reef to keep in poor diversity, like usually one type of bacteria usually overcomes the others. That's not the main idea.
No. No.
So tell us the main idea.
The problem is that we have to deal with many different type of bacteria. And where we have still today at the end, no big idea what's going on. So we have to focus only on this nitrogen source, the nitrogen circle, but we have a lot of other circles around, and we have many, many, many different type of bacteria which can also make shortcuts in the nitrogen cycle. So at the end, every tank is singly for him. Then we have all the bacteria which are in the course. And this biodiversity, we cannot control to a few bacteria which we produce. So the products of bacteria is a good tool. It's an important tool. It can help to solve issues and to get time to find the reason for the issue that we can change the source. For this, the products are very good. I don't say to dose all the time the bacteria in. It makes no sense. You put the bacteria in, they do some work, the skimmer takes them out, and then you have to dose it again. But if you have some issues, like you make a movement, you have some rotten animals because there's a fish dying and it's inside and you need to control it, then you can use the therapy. If you have too much precipitations in the bottom, you can also use the therapy because there are bacteria in which eating the mud. All the things you can do with the bacteria. So they are a really good tool, but a good running tank don't need a bacteria dose. And I don't say it's a good idea to dose that all the time. For me, the bacteria dose is like a little bit an aspirin. But the way is, it's always good to have it at home. But like you use it as a human, is first you drink, then you use the aspirin. The other way is not working. And that's the same with the bacteria. So keep it there. You can use it with the bacto balls for cycling. That's all okay if you have no life rock. Today we have to work with ceramics, with what else we can buy. There is a good sense to fill the surface with bacteria and to bring it more in stability. That's a good idea. But it's not a tool to save money not to buy coral stem. So the way is to add many cores in the tank as fast as possible, with low decoration as possible. Then you have the most possible success. But for movement, for ill animals, if you have fishes lost or something like that, you can add for 2 days, 14 days, you can add bacteria. For cycling or something like that, the bacteria are a good way to keep the stability. For that, this is a tool, not less, but not more. So it's much more important to keep a stable biofilm in the reef tank by the normal work, which is inside the tank, due with normal food. You will have enough bacteria. Also, the myth, if the people say, we dose Dino X, we kill the biology. We dose this, we kill the biology. No, there is... you need to dose antibiotics in very high amount to kill the biology. You change the nutrition levels. This have an effect on the bacteria, but then coming others stronger than it was before. Yes, this is one of the problems. But cyanobacteria, dinoflagellates, gold algae, whatever fuck, has nothing to do with a damaged biology. Absolutely not. It has to do with less elements and with this relation and whatever, but not with the missing bacteria. I know today the people buy it like hell, they keep it in. And so sometimes people claiming this product is not working, it cannot work. No. When you have an open wound, you can take aspirin, it will not close the wound. And this is the point why we have so much myth in this case. So there's no diagnosis. So, okay, what's the problem? How are your parameter? And now which kind of bacteria could help? We have the rebiotic, which is another type of bacteria. This is the dry source bacteria. Yeah, this is something which is only used for problem solving. Let me say large tanks, which you cannot remove the rocks or... If you have such problems, this is a bomb. This is extremely strong. And you can really, about this amount of bacteria, you can give you some time to create a better environmental for the cores to help them out. But this is also, I know people who use it daily and they say they have great success with that. Okay, then they found a good way for what comes in the tank and with the bacteria. but I do not recommend it all the time. I recommend to come back to normal and have these tools as possibility to find back to the right way before adding medicine, before adding the X-series or something like that. So it's first I help with water change, a little bit bacteria, and mostly then I can come back on to the way. And so it's step by step. So how bigger the problem, then the next product coming. So if the bacteria don't work and the water change don't work, then I can go to X, then I make ICP, then I check what is the level, and then I can come back to the way. So
as you've said about rebiotic as a kind of, let's say, restart or regaining that good balance, is that the same way we might think about refactor therapy?
No. I had a customer from Switzerland. She had older tank, and she had a very special cyanobacteria, which grows more like a sponge. Very thick pattern, extremely hard to remove, even if you put the tank in a good level. So I developed for her these type of bacteria, because I said to her, we can do that, but we have to fix all the nitrogen and the phosphorus with something which is stronger than the cyanobacteria. So, and with that, we can bring the cyanobacteria back to grow and will be then destroyed. So that was the reason why I developed sometimes a product. So before, it was not necessary to have such a bomb. And this lady was the reason that I said, okay, we will find a way to solve this issue. That's why we have today this type of dry bacteria. They are really, like I said, I have a big issue, and then I can go in with that without harming the cores or without have too much effect on the nutrient level in the reef tank. But they go in the sponges, they go in the cyanobacteria, and they keep all the nutrients from them away, so they die. So this is the sense behind the things. The bacteriotherapy is more against the smell of the water. These are typical bacteria which going against the smell of the water. There was an idea, was also a lady which blaming that the tanks of her husband is smelling and has ill fish and that. And so I have a look and I talk with some of these producers of bacteria, what we can do, what they have for ideas. And these are really specialists in how bacteria is working and which one. And so we find together a recipe for the seawater. And this is quite good against pathogens. It's cleaning the tank a little bit. And it's okay if you dose both together. This is possible. But my personal meaning for me is it's always better not to dose when it's go for a long time. And if you have a private reef tank which smells like that, you can dose it. That's not a problem. But, you know, I see here from a real reef behind how he take care with his corals, how nice they will be stocked there. I have Euphilias to see, and you also in the backside. And for you guys, it's nothing what you dose the whole day. Yeah. For a customer maybe, which is a normal heavy stocked fish, that's one of the typical things, too much stock of fish, then you can help to reduce the nutrients with the bacteria. In this case, yes, before you add carbon source, before you add a large skimmer or whatever, or if it's not possible because they don't have the money, then you can do it, yes. But for reef tanks lovers who are working like base like that, what I can see now in the background, no. No, because these tanks are healthy, so don't add bacteria, which brings more.
Okay.